Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Swappin' Dre Game Reviews and More. Your host Dustin. I'm actually going to try to adjust this just a little. I'm trying to get some more of that good Horizon Zero Dawn footage and give you guys a little more running commentary while I play. was going to do an article that Game Informer had. I was going to kind of talk about it, about Microsoft's lack of first party titles. Well, read the article over, and basically, let me turn that down just a little bit. Basically says the same thing that everyone else says. They need to focus on this, and they're Microsoft saying just kind of a generic, answer is we're working on it basically, and that's good and all, but it would be nice to see some actual, you know, an actual possible list of upcoming titles. I'd like to see them do some. I know they have like State of Decay 2, I think, Sea of Thieves. well, I'm gonna grab the article and I'll tell you exactly what they said they had coming out. But they're just kind of lackluster, really. Let's see. To talk about how they've been focused on timed exclusives like Rise of the Tomb Raider, which I was very disappointed that they did that, but you know, it's just kind of, let's see, and I'm not seeing, oh here we go, Crackdown 3, Sea of Thieves, and State of Decay 2. These are their first party lineup. Not very promising. Hated Crackdown 1 and 2. Just hated it. They focused more on like an objective base than just, hey, here's the city, run around, blow stuff up. Would have definitely been a little bit better. Because it did have a lot of potential. Loved how you leveled up your hero and everything. That was cool, but right now they're just basically saying the only thing they've got going for them is Horizon. They said it was the only game to crack the 90%, let's see, on Metacritic, Horizon 3. They said new IPs like Sunset Overdrive, ReCore, and Quantum Break either underperform or did not do enough to convince Microsoft to make sequels. So that's kind of a bad news for those franchises that Microsoft's not pursuing. And also says that Microsoft basically has kind of gutted their first-party developers. They scrapped Scalebound and Fable Legends, which we all kind of heard about by now. It talks about how Halo 5 and Gears 4 did not do as well as they thought, but they were also competing against games like Overwatch and Destiny. And those are some big franchises. It also kind of talks about how, where Microsoft's requiring all Xbox One exclusives to come to Windows 10 as well, to make that cross platform thing, that people are basically, there's not much incentive to buy an Xbox One when you can just play it on PC, and you can actually use the Xbox One controller on your PC. So there's not really much of incentive to buy an Xbox One. They're hoping to kind of remedy this with Project Scorpio, and I do hope, you know, they do, you know, kind of fix that. I know Scorpio is going to be pretty big, and I do think when they announce that, they will announce some big titles. It's not like, you know, it's not like them to just kind of leave it hanging. They're going to push some kind of software. Just kind of flipping through the previews here. That BattleTech for PC looks really good. Some sort of mech shoot 'em up top game. Let's see. Splatoon 2. looks like it for the previews, really. Game Informer review and Outlast 2. Gave it a 7.75, which is a decent review. Dragon Quest Heroes 2, a 7.5, also decent. MLB The Show 17 got a 9 out of 10, which is very good, which is always, they always, the MLB Show are always great. Puyo Puyo Tetris, give it a 7. I'm actually considering getting that myself. I've not played a Tetris in forever. I would like to, get another one, because I did enjoy Tetris back in the day. Let's talk to this little dude here and see what we got going on. Well, this is just kind of a random video, but, let's get another drink since the cough's still real. This drink break brought to you by Diet 7-Up again. Those, by the way, are my wife's drinks, so, don't tell her I'm not really supposed to have soda. Even diet, it's the carbonation. It's not the actual soda. It's just the carbonation is bad for my ulcer. But sometimes I wake up thirsty. Sounds like Troy Baker. All right, let's see. Loot the people. Up on the old trusty steed here. Going to the massacre style. Where my people were, the war party was. She wants me to scan something, but I'm not seeing it right now. Maybe it's further up the trail. Yes, so far this game has been super excellent. I have uploaded kind of a progress report on how I've been enjoying it. And I have to say, it is it's an extremely good game. Kind of hide behind him to see if... Oh, it still sees me. Oh, well. Let's get out here and do this. Ooh, I forgot I got that weapon equipped in. He's still after me. Oh, nice. So my, I just got this new gun. I forget what it's called. Basically, it's kind of like a projectile weapon. kind of some sort of projectile weapon, kind of like a gun, I guess, basically. What is happening now? Okay, let's see. It is called the Bolt. Metal Bolt Rattler is what it's called. I'm going to use the bow. The old trusty bow here. Oh, right in the head. Anyway, yes, this game definitely would be a system seller in my opinion. Oh my lord, there's a fish. And I caught it. Sweet. I did not know there was fish in the game, and you can actually shoot those with your bow. It's a trout. I did not know that. That is a pretty sweet little detail they've added here. I love games that just surprise you with the amount of stuff that they put in it. Like I said, this is just a absolute beautiful game. Definitely a system seller. Probably one of my new favorite franchises, actually. Like I said, I saw this game about 3 years ago, I guess it was. I just just saw it was during E3. I think it was E3, like 2014 or something like that. And it was in one of the Game Informers, and all it showed was just a small, like, pick, like this big. And it just basically the cover of the game, her facing off against this giant dinosaur thing. And I just saw that, and I'm like, man, that is going to be an... If that is made well, that will be excellent. And then they said it was made by Guerrilla, which makes this series here, Killzone. Killzone has been a very solid series. None of those games have been bad. Graphics are always good on those. The controls always extremely tight. Just overall, they've been a very good series. I think they could have been a little bit more popular, but they called themselves the Halo Killer. When it came out, it was when Killzone 1 came out, they called themselves the Halo Killer. And that went up against Halo 2. And if you've played Halo 2 and Killzone 1, you know Halo 2 is just the far superior game. I think Halo 2 was the high mark for the entire Halo series. So, you know, it got a lot of, it caught a lot of crap because of that. But, I mean, I'm not throwing off on Guerrilla Games by any means. Their games are excellent. They said they are not done with the Killzone series, which I'm actually kind of glad. But I'm definitely glad to see them move on to Horizon. A great, great new IP. You know, just overall, it's just very, very well done. And I'm glad to see, you know, see them making this. I'm probably going to play a little more of this game, and I hope you guys are enjoying the video. It's been a little bit, kind of a long video so far, but I hope you guys are enjoying it. Let's see, I'm going to mount the old Strider here, and actually, let's see. Okay, there's the ejector, sorry. I was seeing some other little icons popping up. I think it was just the enemies that were looking for me. Alright, we got some elk looking critters that I may possibly even be able to ride. I'm not for sure. Oh, and I missed. I did not miss that one, though. Or that one. Okay. Well. I guess for right now, we're going to try to hop off this thing and see what kind of sneaking we can do. Tie this grass and see if we can approach one of these elk critters. I'm not for sure exactly what they're called. I call them elk because they look at giant, you know, elk. Robot thing. Let's see if we can sneak up on one here. And I can silence strike, but I cannot. Ooh, it's called a grazer. Okay. And so far they're not actually attacking me. This thing is. Yeah, I'll see him. Anyway, he's of course. The watcher is dead with one hit to the eye, and this thing is still after me. Oh, and he is on me. Run! He's still after me. Get off me! Okay. Anyway, for the record, I cannot hack those things. Just gonna try to collect the scrap if it'll let me. Without getting too. Okay, I cannot pick up any more mods, it looks like. And it is still angry. So what we can do to calm the beast. Guess we could always do that. Alright, well, I heal up a little bit. We have some more healing items I can't pick up. Alright, let's see. Yes, this game is so good. If you have yet to play it, I encourage you, if you have a PS4, to pick it up. It is, it's excellent. It really is. It will probably be Sony's exclusive of the year. The only thing I could imagine that would top this one is Uncharted: The Lost Legacy. That would be one I could see actually beating this one, but it would be very hard to do. But I'm also a big Uncharted fan, so I'm actually super stoked that two really good games, really big exclusives, have came out for Sony so far this year. I know there's a lot supposed to come out. You got the new Spider-Man, God of War 3. Uncharted: The Lost Legacy. The Crash Insane Trilogy, which I heard that's just a timed exclusive, and that kind of hurts me because I did love... Excuse me. I love the Crash series, and the original trilogy was only on PlayStation. I know that Activision owns the rights to Crash, and you know they're going to release it on all the platforms, which I can see. I mean, why would they limit their audience? But, you know, I'd still like to see it just be exclusive to Sony. The Jack and Daxter trilogy is supposed to also come out this year. Yeah, just a lot of super great games coming out just for you know, PlayStation's exclusives. Darksiders 3, I know it's not an exclusive, but I think it's definitely worth mentioning that it looks excellent as well. The first two games were very good. I did not beat the second one. I need to revisit that. The first one was really good. Besides the stupid portal stuff, I hated that. Oh my lord, the portal parts were a pain. But the game itself was excellent. But yeah, there's definitely some very big franchises coming this year. I think this will probably be one of the best years in gaming in recent memory. You got Star Wars Battlefront 2 that's coming. COD, World War 2. That's going to be also very, very good. I can't think of all the great exclusives coming this year. You know, the big franchises. I've already seen some very good games get launched. Keep looking up because ready to play some Yooka-Laylee. I also picked up Little Nightmares. I found out the character is called Six. That was the reason the collector's edition is called the Six Edition. It comes with a little figure and stuff. And I have an unboxing video on that, so if you get a chance to check that out, I would advise you to do so. It's pretty cool, the stuff that it came with. Also got the SteamWorld Collection, SteamWorld Heist, and SteamWorld Dig, A Fistful of Dirt. But yeah, these are some of the titles I picked up recently. Also, Mass Effect Andromeda, which I'm sad to report, EA has put the Mass Effect series on hiatus right now. Andromeda did not sell as well as they thought it would, so they have decided to ice the series for a while, which is a real shame. I guess the company that made it, BioWare, it was a certain branch of their office that had been mostly a support group for the different BioWare studios. Apparently, they made this game, and because it didn't perform as well, I guess EA is pretty upset about it, and basically it's kind of just made that studio just support again. I hate to see that, because Andromeda has been really good. And I hope they don't, you know, just kind of, I hope they don't put the series on hold too long, because I think the Mass Effect series is definitely one that we need to see more of. Anyway, guys, this is just, like I said, been kind of just a random video. Just kind of some progress, some gaming news, little bit of game footage here. And anyway, guys, hope you catch the other videos I've uploaded, and stay tuned to the channel. Hit that thumbs up, subscribe. This is Dustin from Swampy Dirt Game Reviews and More, signing out. Have a good day.